Hi guys and welcome to this video. This is Jamie from System22 and GreatWebDesign.com. In this video we're going to add a Facebook feed to our Divi website here. Divi is a WordPress theme by Elegant Themes. It's awesome, I use it all the time. If you're a developer like I am, it's probably the only theme that you're ever going to need. It's got so many features and it just keeps getting better and better. But today I'm going to show you how to add a Facebook feed to your website. This will work for any WordPress theme, so go ahead and follow along. So the first thing we want to do is go to this site here, which is developers.facebook.com. I'll put a link to it below this video. And you want to put your Facebook or whatever Facebook feed you'd like to add in this little box here. Once you do, it'll pop up below. For instance, I've got mine in here. And then you want to decide how you'd like it to display. You can put a custom width and height in. I'll just put, say, 450 by 600. This is pixels. Or if you don't, you can just check that little box right there. And this is the feed that it's going to display there, which works pretty well for me. Now I don't know if I want that header in there, so I can check that and say hide cover photo. Let's have a look at the small header option. Yeah, I think that's actually okay with that one before. That's fine. And you can decide whether you want to show your friends' faces there. I think for my website that would be fine to go without that. So once you've decided how you'd like it to display, go ahead and click the little blue Get Code button here. This is really easy. Now it's going to pop up this window and you may freak out and say, oh, what's all that? Well, don't even worry about it. We're not going to use the JavaScript option on this. We're going to use the iframe option, which is a lot easier. I'll just make that box a bit bigger. And this is the iframe code, which will display it in a little frame of its own. So all you need to do is select that code by left clicking and dragging across it, and then right click and hit copy or control C on your keyboard. Once we've got that code, let's go to our site. You want to decide where you're going to put it. I think I'll put it just under this right here. So let's go to the page editor. And what I'll do is I'll copy a section and just bring it up. This is the Divi Builder plugin right here. And again, it's really easy to use. And you can get things working very quickly with it indeed. Let's just swap these around. As you'll see, you can move any blocks around, your text blocks, your image blocks, however you want them. And to copy a block, you just hit that little button there and it'll copy it and duplicate it underneath, and you can re-edit without having to change any of the styles. So I'm going to get rid of this and I'm going to just put a regular text module in there. And for anybody not using the Divi, you can just use a regular text box or post blog, whatever, however your particular WordPress theme likes to do things. And once you're in it, you want to go over to the text version, not the visual version, the text version, and you'll see all this change up here. When you hit visual, it's got the little icons there. When you hit the text, it's got these ones here. Just click on there and paste in control V or right click and paste our iframe code that we brought over from the last site. I'm going to save and exit. Going to update that. And we'll go ahead and preview our changes. If we take a look now, there we have it. There's our Facebook feed there. Don't like that color back there, so let's just change that color, the background color of that. So So I've got it in with those circle counters. Okay. I'll just add a new section. Let's just pop all those up to there. And delete that one. And now update that. And when we go back, it should be in a white section rather than that dark section. So it should look a lot better. There we go. That's a bit more what I was looking to get there. And there's our Facebook feed here. If I just roll this down a little bit. And people can scroll all the way down. They can see all your posts from way back when. They can just keep scrolling because it's just feeding it straight from your Facebook page there, which is just what we want. So how easy was that? That is how easy it is to add a Facebook feed to your WordPress website. I hope that's been useful to you. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and GreatWebDesign.com. I'll leave a link to the Facebook developers page under this video here, and also a link if you want to get the Divi theme. If you've enjoyed this, please subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.